Thank you so much for joining us on this beautiful Friday. I hope you're enjoying our wonderful weather like I am. As you know, as seasons change, that means it's a change in weather. And what's special about here in Imperial County, as it starts to cool down, we are able to start growing vegetables and different fruits and vegetables. And this is not just in Imperial Valley, throughout California, we're able to grow different things in different seasons. So the thing I have showed on sharing on the screen is something put out by California Grown. And it says eat the seasons. So it's telling you what things, what fruits and vegetables are being grown in California or being in the grocery store in California in different seasons. So these are all fruits and vegetables that come from California, and this is when you can find them in the grocery store. So this is a very important thing that you can share with your parents. So when you go to the grocery store, you know what's available. Farmers in Imperial Valley are growing vegetables right now that are going to be in our grocery stores very soon. So they are growing them, and then they'll start harvesting them soon, and they'll be in our grocery stores. But we have Miss Cher Watte Angulo, we'll call her Mrs. Angulo, here today, and she is from California Grown. Now, she's going to be walking us through the grocery store. She's going to be showing us a lot of labels. So I wanted to give you an example of the labels that she would be showing today. It's something called a PLU code. Now, a PLU code stands for price lookup code. And if you see right when you go to the grocery store, you've probably seen this. You can type in the chat box if you've seen this before. There are little labels, little stickers that come on most of our fruits and vegetables. And Ms. Cher will talk about things, maybe some that aren't on there, but most fruits and vegetables, yeah, I see some yeses, yes. Most fruits and vegetables have that little sticker. And that sticker tells us a lot about where our food comes from. And so Ms. Cher is going to talk about some of the labels that you find in the grocery store and how you can tell where they come from and a little bit about her organization called California Grown.
Good morning, everybody. My name is Cher Watte Angulo, and I am the executive director of an organization called Buy California, California Grown. And the purpose of the organization is to teach Californians how to be Californians and buy California. And that means food, fiber, plants, nursery, and flowers. And I'm going to show you how, when you walk through a grocery store, how to know where your food comes from. The information is everywhere, and I'm going to teach you how to find it. Just to begin, I should tell you that it is federal law that all perishable commodities are labeled for country of origin. So it's pretty easy to find out where your fruits and vegetables come from, but it's a little bit more difficult to identify in other crops around the grocery store. We're gonna take a little tour, and I'm gonna show you what it is that you need to look for when finding out where your food comes from. We're gonna begin with what Stacy mentioned with regard to labeling of California Grown. First of all, I'm gonna share with you, this is very simple. This is what I do every Wednesday. When the circular comes out for the grocery store, I look and I identify what's in the grocery store that's California grown. They are identifying that they have grapes grown in California. So that tells me if I go to Vaughn's any day this week, I'm going to find California grown grapes, and we'll go there and we'll look at them. But another way that you can tell California grown is in clear labeling on the packaging. And actually, let me go back to the grapes really quick. Sorry, we did a little pre-shopping to show you. These are the grapes that are on ad. And if we have time while we're walking through, we'll go and look at the display. But this is a package from Castle Vineyards that says product of the USA. But we know they're Californian because the ad says they're from California. But some retailers go to an even greater extent and label their actual packaging California. So these are Pandal California Sweet. And one other little tidbit I can tell you, like I said, packaging reveals a lot. This package is prepared in both English, French. Does anybody know why their packaging is done in English and in French? Okay, so one of the things I mentioned is that Buy California helps people buy California and prepare California products. One of the ways we do that is with our own brand. This is the California Grown brand. If you see this brand on any item, you know it was grown in California. Another way that Stacy explained that you can identify country of origin is by looking for the PLU code. You're probably one of the 1% of the population that now knows what PLU stands for. But you also know, you've noticed that that's what the cash register, the cashier uses to identify the price of each item as they put it across the scanner. But it also provides a whole bunch of other information. And as Stacy illustrated before, the PLU has the PLU code, including the PLU number, sometimes the company name, and product of the USA. So that is another very important method for you to use to identify where your food comes from. I have examples of that throughout my little box that I pre-shop, and we'll go through that as we walk through the store. The third method to identify country of origin is the store placard, and so we'll get there as well. But let's go ahead and talk about two other ways that you can identify where product comes from. Stacy shared the seasonality chart. So let's take a walk and we'll talk about seasonality and where you can find things in the grocery store currently that are in season from California. Okay. Usually those are the items that are on ad, and there's the display of the California grapes that show you two different types of grapes marked for California grown. Okay, we're gonna stop at the lemons. Lemons are a good example of a commodity that is coming into season from California. So I have a sample here of two different packages of lemons that are in the grocery store today, including the loose lemon. So as a consumer, I'm going to look for the country of origin. Chile. Sunkist is a California company, but they're marketing it this time, Chilean lemons. But if I look at this package of lemons, it says product of the USA. So even though a commodity is in season in California, it is not necessarily stocked in your grocery store. If you know it's in season, you want California grown, the best way to ensure that is to actually ask your retailer to stock it. The produce manager is my best friend. That's Jesus over there. Now we're going to take a little walk and talk about other things that are in season. And on our way, we're going to talk about the country of origin on the actual store placard. And here is an example. They don't put PLU codes on potatoes. I guess they don't stick. How do you identify the country of origin? It's on the store signage. So you have to look at the point of sale for the country of origin of these potatoes. I haven't looked at this, but let's see. This is Melissa, another California company, and they are marketing Idaho potatoes. And this is the Idaho label that is comparable to the California grown label that I showed you earlier. So we're going to take a walk around the other side, and we're going to show you some other commodities that are in season. Right now, my family is making a lot of squash and sweet potatoes. These are both great examples of California products that are currently in season that you'll find in your grocery store. See, product of USA. How do I know that's California? Right now, I know that California is producing the majority of the sweet yams in the marketplace. Okay. Another commodity that's in season are pomegranates. Pomegranates also are predominantly produced in California. That's my last tip on how you know that you are getting California grown. Not only do you check seasonality, but you also need to know what commodities are predominantly produced in California. And I have a list of those I can share with you. But if you can think of any, put them in the chat box and we'll discuss that later as well. This is a product of USA, another California marketing company, Palm Wonderful. And you can see that it's a product of USA. And it's most likely from California. Could be Arizona, but most likely California. This is like an example. I'm going to give you a tip. This is an example of a commodity that's 98% produced in California within the United States. There is no regulation on how big the font has to be for products that are not produced or anywhere. I mean, this is product of Peru. And that's pretty good size font, but sometimes it's really teeny weeny and it's very hard to see what the country of origin is, or it's stamped onto the package and it's hard to read against the pack, against the product. So you have to be kind of a detective and look at the packaging to identify what it is or where it is that that commodity comes from. So I grabbed two commodities from the same company. Does anybody recognize Majesty? They are a huge producer of melons, asparagus, and other commodities operating out of Brawley. So here's another trick. I'm not saying they trick, but this is something else that they do. So this is clearly identified as product of Peru. But if you turn over the bunch tag, it should have the marketed by information. We'll find another example of that. But sometimes if you're walking through the grocery store, the packaging will say marketed by such and such company in Salinas, California, but it's product of Mexico. So read beyond the marketed by to the country of origin. These are two examples of a local marketer who is globally sourcing for year-round supply because they need to make sure that the retailers have cantaloupes 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 12 months a year. So this cantaloupe is from the USA. Are we growing cantaloupes right now? No. So this is a USA product, but they're sourcing it from another area. Most likely this is coming out of Arizona and maybe out of Northern California. So that's a good observation of how it might be a local marketer who's also sourcing year round, which is a good thing because that gets their label in the marketplace 24/7. So it's not a bad thing. Here's an example, another seasonality. This is an Ocean Mist, another California marketer of a globe artichoke. See how small, I don't know why it's so small on this. See how small that USA is? It doesn't matter as long as it's marked. And that is a California artichoke because California grows 99% of the US production of artichokes. We're gonna go over to garlic. I think I taught Stacy and Stephanie something when I taught them this. Okay, how do you identify garlic as United States garlic? Well, I don't see it there, which it should be. I think we had this problem last week too. So it's not clearly labeled. And garlic does come from several different sources. So how do you know it's California garlic or US garlic? Here's the tip. If you look at the very tip of the garlic, you see little plant roots. That means it's California. If it was from China, which is the major importer of garlic into the United States, it would have no roots, because of what is called phytosanitary regulations. And phytosanitary means plant health. So there might be a disease or pest in garlic roots in China that we don't want here. So they scrape them clean. There's an example here of some that look like there were. Okay, we'll see. But if you go to, and you look and you're an informed consumer, you'll start looking to make sure that your garlic has roots. This one looks like it's been slightly scraped, but you wouldn't see any plant material on imported garlic. I'm gonna make a quick U-turn and we're gonna go over to the bananas. What is it about bananas that is so important to the California economy? We don't grow bananas, we grow some. I think there's a couple of groves up in the Santa Barbara area, but these bananas come from Costa Rica. And there are some over here that come from Ecuador, mainly a South American commodity. How do they get here? They get here by big boat and they're shipped green and then they are brought to the grocery store sometimes like this so they can ripen on your counter. But what's important? What makes that important to California? If you are ever in San Diego and you notice all of the dole boats at the San Diego port, that's what makes it important to California. All the imported bananas that are imported require people to unload and move, including the truck drivers that move the product to the grocery store. So even though it's not a California grown product, it's important to our economy. Okay, this is Earthbound Farms. It happens to be an organic product from Earthbound Farms. Let's go and look at the marketing. I'm sure they have the marketing. Okay, so if you look here, it says Earthbound Farms in Salinas. That might tell you the country of origin. No, that tells you what company marketed the product. Country of origin is very clearly up in the right-hand corner. They are nice. They stamp it against a blue background so you can see it. There are a lot of examples where it's kind of blended into the product. We'll talk about that too. What's significant about this is if you follow the news, you know that sometimes we have some food safety concerns with romaine and they have to recall the product because there's some concern about it having a problem. So the leafy green industry has actually gone beyond the country of origin or the state of origin. They've got region. This number here traces that product all the way back to the field, the space in the field that was harvested, and the people that harvested that product. So if you're an informed consumer, you'll know to look for these things. And if there's a recall, then you know what to look for as far as the lot number. It will be pulled, but just so you know, that's so, another tip.
So lots of tracking that goes on with our food. So they know if something happens, they know exactly where it was grown and what field it was grown in.
And they can quickly retract it from the marketplace so that there's no danger to the consumer. Correct. Yeah. So there's, if you also look at labels in the grocery store, it tells you a whole bunch of information. This packaging talks about recycled packaging, USDA organic. If you scan on that little QR code, you see that little QR code it's going to try to hook us up. If you see a QR code like that on packaging, it'll direct you to the company's website for additional information on that packaging, or I'm sorry, on that product, including maybe recipes on how to prepare it. That's something that Buy California does a lot of. We spend a great deal of time creating recipes to help teach you all how to more creatively use California-grown products in your own home. Also, eat them in restaurants. Okay, so the other thing that is on this package is grown without GMOs. So if you look at the package, it tells a big story about the production chain of this particular commodity. And that's just one example. They're throughout the grocery store. Here's another example of what's in season. These are California navel oranges. They are in season in California, and it says product of USA. How do I know that's California? Well, I know that Kern Ridge is in California and is a California company. So that's how I know. I also know because they're in season. Kiwi is another prime example. What does that label say? You see the top green lettering? What does that say? Some of the company, California Kiwi Packers. Oh, I thought it was a brand. Anyway, that is another example of a California commodity that's currently in season, not produced here, but currently in season. Kiwi has the most interesting crop to see in the field. They're like bushes, and they grow all up the northern, central California, northern corridor of California. And you might driving think that they're really big grape, they don't look like grapevines, but pretty, because they look like bushes. They're tall bushes that resemble a nut tree, but they are lower and more dense. And if you are in the grocery store, you'll see we have the green kiwi, the golden kiwi, very high in nutrients and really versatile to use. Another, I can't believe I forgot one of my favorites. Okay, California figs, folks. If you haven't had a fig, try one. They are delicious. And there are plenty of recipes on how to use them on our website, californiagrown.org. So check that out. Okay, so this is a California fig product, definitely in season. This is their high season for this variety of fig. And they very clearly label that it's a California fresh fig. Okay, got so much to share. A local product. We grow these here. We grow them in the Coachella Valley. This is a Bard Valley product. Here's a good example of kind of camouflaging the country of origin. Could you guys see that? It says product of USA stamped onto the side package, and it kind of blends into the color of the commodity, but this is product of USA. Again, I know that it's California because Bard Valley is a California company, and Bard Valley is a California geographic destination or designation.
Bard Valley, like the world's most, it's up at the world level as far as production of dates now?
Yeah, they are one of the largest marketers of dates in the world. Yes, absolutely. Yeah.
And that's, and again, that's in Imperial County. So that's somewhere in our county that does that.
The two biggest production regions for dates in California are in Southern California, Imperial, and in Coachella. So here's an example of the nuts. I don't know if we talked about this before. By the way, these two companies are related, just in case anybody cares. They have the Palm label and they have the Wonderful label. You see the heart in both. That's part of their branding. Nuts are not required to be labeled. But again, another tip, I'm going to give all the answers before you guys get the end of the tour quiz. Nuts, these two nuts, 98-99% produced in California. Same with these. Here's another great California company. And their packaging, they do list product of California. Yeah, Marini Nut Company in Winters, California, product of California. Okay, we're gonna take a walk and go look at other parts of the grocery store. So here's an example, pumpkin seeds. Okay, pumpkins are grown in California and we've been marketing a ton of pumpkins, and you would think that maybe you might see some pumpkin seed from California. Well, I scoured the store only because I was curious, and I noticed that these are from Bulgaria. Oh, where did I see that? Bulgaria. Who can find Bulgaria on the map? And these are from China. Where's the packaging? Roasted in the USA, product of China. So consumer beware, a product might be produced within the United States or put together in the United States, but be the raw ingredients might be the product of another country. I mentioned that federal law requires perishable commodities to be labeled. One of the missing links in the labeling are meat products. Meat's perishable, right? Okay, well, in Congress, they kind of separated out meat products from fresh fruits and vegetables because there wasn't unanimous consent about labeling of meat products. And that's because if you're going to put hamburger through the grinder, you're not 100% sure that's all coming from the same cow that was grown in Iowa or wherever. So when you look at a meat product, it'll have the USDA labeling as to how it was graded, but it does not offer any information about country of origin. That is not true for a lot of other meat products. Fish products are also labeled. So this is a Maine salmon product. No, actually, I'm wrong. Look, what does that say? Naturally smoked in Maine. I'm being duped. Where is it from? Duck Trap River of Maine. Okay, there you go. But you have to really look to make sure that you're getting the full information. Sometimes it's hidden, product of Australia. So here's an example of a lamb meat product that is indeed labeled. Okay, now we're gonna go over to the dairy department. Does anybody know how high dairy ranks in California production? Can anybody tell me what the number one ag state is in the nation? Does anybody know what ranking Imperial County is in California as far as ag producing county?
I'm gonna let people try to guess in the chat. Who is the number one? What state is the number one producer of dairy? Dairy is milk products. So
all milk dairy, products.
All milk products. And then what state is the number one agriculture state in all of the nation? So let's go ahead and take a guess in the chat box if you think you know the answer.
And I also want to note, I don't know if you explicitly outlined this, but what ranking is the Imperial County in all of California? It's pretty impressive.
Yeah. So Imperial County, where do you think we rank? What number are we? Oh, us, Leda Martinez answered California. California is the number one dairy state and the number one state for agriculture in all of the United States. California is number one. Now let's guess what number is Imperial County? Give me a number. There's 58 counties in California. Am I correct? 58 counties in California. What number is Imperial County for agriculture? We have someone's guessing number one, number four.
Nope.
Not none of those. Not number three.
Nope.
We have 15, five. Nope. I don't see the answer yet. 56. Give us the answer, Cher. What number are we?
We are ranked ninth.
Ninth.
We have been higher. And actually, I'll just give you a little tidbit. Back in the, I want to say 1950s, Orange County, you know, where Disneyland is located, that was number one in 1950. So things change very quickly as the world changes. And we are now number nine. I think we've been in the top 10 since I've been alive. But we have vacillated between, I think, 6 and 9 is where I've noticed that we've been able to stay. But we clearly produce more than, let me see and make sure you get this number correctly, more than $2 billion in agricultural products comes out of this county.
$2 billion, okay. That's a big number.
That is a big number, and it supports a lot of our jobs. I have a bumper sticker on my car that says, my job depends on ag. Okay, do they maybe drink almond milk? Again, a California company, Blue Diamond, Blue Diamond, located up in Sacramento, California. It doesn't say that it's from California. There's no labeling, except the back has a beautiful story about the California farmer that produces the almonds that's used to make this particular product. Just wanted to point that out. Okay, now we're going to go down to actual milk. How do you know that you're getting milk from happy cows from California? Let's go for the whole milk. Does anybody see it? California Real Milk Seal. That is a seal of the California milk producers, folks. And they put it on all of their California milk products. You'll see Lucerne definitely has it all over their products. We didn't check Fairlife. But if you are an aware consumer, here is the Safeway brand. There you are, Happy Cows, California milk.
Well, we do have a lot of comments of people that do like almond milk and traditional milk. I just want to make sure everyone knows, do you know where milk comes from? And you could type your answer in the chat. Where does milk come from? What animal gives us milk? Cows, dairy cows. Are there any other animals that can give us milk that we can drink? Goats, you're right. You can have, we can drink milk from goats. We can make cheese out of sheep's milk. And then there's also a camel dairy. Some people even drink camel milk. There's a camel dairy in San Diego.
Ramona, so, California.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Maybe someday you'll drink camel milk as well.
I understand it's very close to human milk, as a matter of fact. Okay. This is an example of consumer awareness. Just because these eggs are labeled California CEFS compliant, does not mean it's California grown. What that means is that these eggs were produced according to California standards. And I at this time cannot tell you what SCFS stands for, but it is a state law that you all passed, or those of you that are voting age, I think 4 years ago, regarding the production standards of eggs that were marketed in California. So buyer beware, not necessarily produced in California, but produced to California standards. Okay, now we're gonna go look at another dairy product that has the California seal, sour cream. And my favorite cheese in the supermarket, the quesadilla cheese, California milk. So look for the California label. It's not on everything. And cows are produced in most states in the United States. So, you know, the cheese is made everywhere. There's a company, a very famous cheese company in Washington State, Tillamook. Sargento, yeah, Tillamook. So if you buy Tillamook, you know that is, Oregon. So an Oregon company, someplace in the south, in the northwest, right? But you can also see on their labeling that they are promoting that their cows are not treated with RBST. RBST is a hormone used in the production of milk. Milk requires hormones. If you are producing milk, you have hormones. So this is just a marketing label that they use that their cows are not treated with RBST.
You mentioned to look for the California seal. What is special about California and how farmers grow our food or make our milk and things like that?
How much time do we have? I think just speaking from, you know, why is it that California has so much agriculture? It's our climate, it's our soil, it's the people that, you know, my family has been farming for 100 years. You have a great deal of knowledge and tremendous soil profiles, and you have a Mediterranean climate that produces a whole variety of commodities. You know, we're one of the only places in the world that they grow these. Only place in the world they grow these. Only place, or one of the only places they grow this, these, those, Brussels sprout, you name it. You know, we grow 400 different commodities in California. And it's the people, it's the environment, and it is the climate. I can also add that we also produce our commodities up to the highest standards in the world. The farmers in California are required to produce not only to California standards and US standards, but if they're marketing overseas, they have to produce to French standards and anybody else. So they are at the top of their game. They have experts in the field that are evaluating for pests, for diseases, for food safety concerns, for water quality. It's very state of the art. And if you are interested in a career in agriculture, it runs the gamut. You don't have to be a farmer. You can be a pest advisor. You can be a marketer of agricultural products. There's a whole bunch of jobs. We need scientists that are looking at new varieties that are trying to eradicate pests and diseases. Whatever your interest is, you can apply it to agriculture. And we need young people to help us to stay cutting edge. Okay, now, pardon me, we are going to migrate over to my son's favorite meal, which is pasta. Anybody know why we stopped here? Does anybody know what pasta is made from? Does anybody know what this is?
Let's see if anybody can answer that in the chat box. Let us know, what is she holding? What is pasta made from? It is wheat. Great job. We have someone from Mrs. Charlton Moore's class that answered wheat.
Yay. Okay. So this is wheat. This is what you see growing out in our fields. You'll see that it gets the big green, wavy fields of green that then turn to yellow, and then big combines come out and harvest it up. So what makes it unique that this is California wheat, or I should say Imperial Valley wheat? This is an example of durum. It's a variety called durum that is predominantly used in the production of pasta. Okay, so this box says that it's an Italian produced commodity. But because the ingredient label includes durum wheat, durum wheat flour, you can be pretty certain that when you go to the grocery store and pick up a box of Barella penne pasta, it contains product grown right here in the Imperial Valley. Highly sought after commodity is our durum wheat. And also, if you want some really good pasta recipes, including like soups with pasta in it, go to our website. We'll tell you how to add kale and other good veggies to a soup or to any recipe to help you elevate it and make it more nutritious and fun to cook. Okay, we're gonna end in the olive oil department. So olive oil is something that is produced throughout the state of California. I know that it's produced in most regions. Did you all know that we have olive trees here in the Imperial Valley, and we have local olive producers with local mills that are producing local olive oil? Okay, so this is an example of an olive oil that is labeled as California Olive Ranch. That's the brand name. So when you pick this up, do you think you're getting California olive oil? Yeah, you would assume, because it's labeled California, that it might be California product. If you read more closely, the banner here says Argentina, Chile, Portugal, and California. So this olive oil is actually a blend of olive oils from those regions. Okay, and it doesn't have, there's seals, but it doesn't have the California seal. Okay, but it is extra virgin olive oil. There's California Reserve. Let's see. So this does say, this does stipulate that the reserve collection features exclusively California extra virgin olive oil. So you just have to look a little deeper so that you know what you're buying. I'm not saying this is bad. I have all sorts of different qualities of olive oil in my cabinet. I mean, extra virgin oil, virgin, so on and so forth, cold pressed, you name it. The difference is you see, this very large bottle is $20 and this much smaller bottle is $15. So you're gonna pay more for the reserve all California extra virgin. Another example of all California is this one labeled as California extra virgin olive oil. And it not only stipulates that it's California first cold press extra virgin oil, it carries the symbol of the California Olive Oil Council. Okay. So that's just a way to read other labels outside of the produce department. I mentioned at the very beginning, there are a number of commodities that are exclusively produced in California or predominantly produced in California. I also mentioned we grow 400 different commodities. This is the list of the commodities that are majorly produced in the state of California. And the highlighted commodities of almonds, artichokes, dates, figs, garlic, grapes as raisins, kiwi fruit, honeydew melons, olives, cling peaches, pistachios, sweet rice, and walnuts. And this information can be found on the California Department of Food and Agriculture's website, along with other statistics.
Well, thank you so much for joining us today, Mrs. Angulo. We had a great time learning about how to read labels, how to find out where our food comes from, because that is very important. When we are buying things, we're consumers, we want to know where our food comes from. And we are very proud of our California farmers because they work very hard to make sure our food is safe and delicious and the freshest that it can be when we buy it at the grocery store. So thank you again for joining us. And thank you to all of our teachers and participants. Thanks, guys. You have a great day, everyone. Happy Friday.
Take care.